So, the cause of obesity, we have a lot of reasons for it. We have someone mentioned stress, quit caring. I hear that a lot. Oh, I quit caring about myself. I love food, is to die for, things like that. But the only cause for obesity, and a lot of surgeons and medical professionals are gonna dislike this statement, but I'll tell you, the only cause for obesity is what you eat, period. It's food, period. It's not carbs, it's not fat, it's not junk. It is exactly what you put in your mouth. Now, let me explain to you this way. Imagine you have this little baby, a newborn baby. What turns a newborn baby into a grown man or woman? The only answer is what? What you put in your mouth. What you put in that baby's mouth. That's it, right? So if you think it's stress, you could put that baby under a lot of stress. If you don't feed that baby, guess what? That baby's gonna die. You might think it's love. Oh, my husband, loves me too much and he cooks all the stuff. If it's love, it's good to love the baby, but if you don't feed it, that baby's gonna die. That's it. The only thing that turns a baby from a baby to a grown-up is gonna be food. What you feed it, what you allow it to drink, etc. And that's no difference, because at one point in your life you were also that baby. So that still applies to you if you're struggling with your weight. Okay? And I can't make it any simpler than that. I mean, that is it. To turn a newborn baby to a grown-up, it just takes food, and that's it. But here's the follow-up point I want to tell you. Why you stay obese is a different question, isn't it? And that's the point we're missing in medicine and in obesity surgery right now. We keep talking about the cause of obesity as being hormones or genetics. And there's a lot of research over that stuff, right? But that's not the truth. The truth is the only cause of obesity is what you put in your mouth, period. Now, why you put that stuff in your mouth, that's a different question. But it's not the cause of obesity. Why you put that stuff in your mouth is a different question. Stress from work, bad relationship, the past, abused as a child, all sorts of reasons that I hear. Okay? And to take it one step further, why we remain obese is a different question also. And you gotta think about it that way. Once you're obese, what makes you stay there? Maybe that's genetics, maybe that's hormones, maybe that's a medical issue, maybe that's a low thyroid, maybe now you're taking insulin, which drives everything you eat into fat. Maybe that's why you stay there, and that's why you need to have weight loss surgery to get you over that hump. But the truth of the matter is, there's a lot of people who are super overweight. You see it on TV all the time, biggest losers. 400, 500 pound people that without weight loss surgery, just by changing what they eat, will start to lose weight. And that's it. So those are two very different issues. And I would like to challenge our patients, but also the healthcare professionals, to really refine what they're trying to say. The cause of obesity, I promise you, is what you put in your mouth, because if you put nothing in your mouth, eventually you would die. Isn't that truth? That's the truth. Eventually, every single one of us would die, would shrink to nothing and die if you put nothing in your mouth. Okay? So, to get rid of obesity, you quit putting stuff in your mouth. Now, why you stay awake? Why we stay obese? That's a different question. Okay? And I don't want us to confuse those issues anymore. And until you get to the real issues about why you're staying obese, right? Weight loss surgery won't work for you long term, or any diets won't work for you long term. Any diets, okay? So that's what I try to do with my patients in our programs, get them to understand that. Okay? But at the end of the day, what makes a baby a grown up is what they put in their mouth. And that doesn't change, because you at one point you were that baby. Cool?